Well, now to the big headline for everyone traveling and going through security at the airport for the first time since 9/11. The TSA is allowing some knives on board planes. The announcement has been greeted with outrage by flight attendants. ABC's David Curley has the story.
An abrupt reversal this morning. After a decade of banning and confiscating pocket knives, the government will now allow small knives on planes, drawing an immediate angry response from flight attendants.
It's going to create passenger confusion, and it's also going to bring a weapon on board. It doesn't make any sense to allow knives on board aircraft.
This is what will be allowed on planes in a month and a half. Small folding knives with a blade shorter than 2.36 inches and a half inch wide. Rules relax too to carry on golf clubs, pool cues, lacrosse and hockey sticks. The TSA says it's all about risk assessment. Every month at the 20 largest airports, 4 tons of knives are confiscated.
We need to keep the screening lines moving at this point and looking for tiny little objects that are not likely to be used to hijack an airplane is really just going to slow things down.
The head of the TSA told airline officials he wants to concentrate on what really worries him, explosives, especially the liquid explosives, which are difficult to detect. Flight attendants complain there is an irony in this change by TSA. While these small pocket knives will be allowed, box cutters, like the ones used to hijack the planes on 9/11, are still banned. They cannot be carried onto a plane.
Well, George? Thank goodness for that, David. Thanks very much.